Samsung is one of the world's largest technology companies. As of the time of writing, Samsung's market capitalization, which is an indicator to understand a company's valuation, is over $279 billion. This puts them as the 32nd largest company globally, just behind companies like Salesforce, Bank of America, Netflix, but above companies like Chevron, ASML, and T-Mobile. Furthermore, the Samsung brand is synonymous to technology itself, just like other major American brands like Apple, Google, Microsoft, and Facebook. It is a company that has always been at the forefront of innovation. They are known for their quality smartphones and memory chip businesses. Unfortunately, Samsung has stumbled upon a major challenge recently, and that challenge is costing them billions of dollars. In the past few years, we have seen a rise in the entire semiconductor industry. Nvidia, AMD, Broadcom, ASML, and so on have been staging huge growth in their financial statements, which resulted in billions to hundreds of billions of market capitalization gain. Just take a look at this chart, showing the market cap growth year after year of major semiconductor stocks. Nvidia has been the outlier here, rising from a mere $100 billion company to more than $3 trillion in just 4 years. This was widely attributed to the artificial intelligence revolution that we see today. This very industry was fueled by one critical component: semiconductors. Semiconductors have fueled this so-called AI boom. Semiconductors are used to power everything from smartphones and computers to the vast data centers that make artificial intelligence possible. Without advanced semiconductors, the AI revolution we're witnessing today would not be feasible. But it is in this very same industry that Samsung has been lagging behind. The industry that we're talking about is the so-called foundry market. In simpler terms, a foundry company like TSMC and Samsung manufactures semiconductors on behalf of other companies. These companies, also known as fabless firms, design the chips but rely on foundries to produce them at scale. The top fabless firms are the likes of Nvidia, Broadcom, and AMD, whereas the foundry companies are TSMC, Samsung, and Global Foundries. And unfortunately, it is in this very industry that Samsung has been lagging behind. It is a very big reason why TSMC is now worth over $1 trillion, because they capture a majority part of this entire foundry market. Here's a graph of the foundry market share. It paints a clear picture why Samsung has been lagging behind TSMC. Back in 2019, Samsung had foundry revenue share of 19.1%, whilst TSMC with 48.1%. This gap isn't significant, and Samsung as a major firm back then was above TSMC. Here's a comparison of Samsung's market capitalization to TSMC from 2016 to 2019. It shows that Samsung was a more valuable company overall. To top it off, Samsung was earning a lot more money than TSMC. Here are the financial statements of both companies. Samsung's gross profits and net income were leagues above TSMC. That simply means that Samsung was receiving a lot more money every year compared to TSMC from 2014 to 2020. Yet, as the AI boom occurred, everything changed. TSMC not only went on to earn much more money, but just look at the market share in 2024. Samsung is left with a mere 11%, while TSMC's market share grew to a massive 61.7%, eating more than half of the entire revenue share of the foundry market. So, does this mean that Samsung is losing the so-called chip war? Are they losing out on this massive billion-dollar potential to a company that they were once leagues above? Well, let's break this down one by one. The first problem that Samsung stumbled upon is due to delays. In semiconductor manufacturing, process technology refers to the method used to create integrated circuits, with smaller nanometer, NME, measurements indicating more advanced and efficient chips. Samsung has faced notable delays in developing its 2-nanometer process technology. Reports indicate that the company has postponed mass production of 2-nanometer chips to 2026, primarily due to low yield rates. Only 10% to 20% of chips produced meet quality standards. TSMC's yield rates and other competitors, on the other hand, are significantly higher, typically achieving 70 to 80% yield rates at similar advanced nodes. This discrepancy in yield rates gives TSMC a clear advantage, as they can produce more functioning chips from each wafer, ultimately lowering production costs and increasing profitability. Higher yield rates also mean faster time to market for clients, making TSMC the preferred choice for tech giants needing reliable and efficient manufacturing. Samsung's low yield rates for 2-nanometer chips are largely attributed to its struggles with extreme ultraviolet lithography, a crucial technology for producing smaller, more complex chips. EUV lithography is essential in achieving high precision at advanced nodes, and TSMC has excelled in integrating this technology into its process. While Samsung has invested in EUV equipment, industry experts note that Samsung's EUV process lacks the maturity and efficiency of TSMC's, which has been perfecting this technology since its 5-nanometer production. This lag in EUV technology development further hampers Samsung's yield rates, complicating its efforts to compete with TSMC in the high-end semiconductor market. Another contributing factor to Samsung's yield issues is the complexity involved in shrinking transistors down to 2 nanometers. Each reduction in process size introduces new engineering challenges, as smaller transistors increase the risk of defects. TSMC has managed these complexities through extensive R&D and iterative improvements, allowing them to build a stable 3-nanometer node and proceed confidently toward 2 nanometers. Samsung, however, is still grappling with stabilizing its 3-nanometer process, let alone moving to 2 nanometers with competitive yields. Then, there's also project delays. Samsung recently introduced their new $17 billion semiconductor plant in Taylor, Texas. Initially slated to commence production in 2024, the project has faced multiple delays. In December 2023, reports indicated that mass production was postponed to 2025 due to construction and equipment delivery challenges. A third challenge to Samsung's business is because of their memory chip dominance. Currently, Samsung is a leader in the production of memory chips such as DRAM and NAND flash. As of 2024, the company held a 42.2% share of the global DRAM market. This is one of the reasons why Samsung fell off against TSMC. They were specializing in another big industry, which is making them a lot of money. Unfortunately, this very industry has also been fraught with challenges for Samsung. Recently, Samsung faced delays in developing and mass-producing its HBM3 and HBM3E chips. These delays have resulted in missed opportunities to supply key clients, allowing SK Hynix to capture significant market share. Just take a look at the recent quarterly results from both companies. Samsung had recorded massive growth in its memory business, over 142% year-over-year from 8.97 trillion Korean won in the past quarter of 2023 to over 21.74 trillion Korean won by the second quarter of 2024. Unfortunately, the operating profit of this segment had only grown by 10.81% year over year. Comparatively, SK Hynix has recorded big operating profits. In the last quarter, the company saw a loss in operating profit of 1.7 trillion won. But in this quarter, they saw a big profit of over 7 trillion won. This is much more than the entire operating profit of Samsung's device solutions, which not only includes memory, but also other businesses. If we take a look at the market capitalization of both companies, we will again see that Samsung is really falling off hard. Samsung's market cap had dramatically fallen from more than $400 billion in the mid of 2024 to just around $280 billion as of the time of writing. Comparatively, SK Hynix has gained a lot, as clearly depicted in the graph. This again puts another pressure on Samsung on the entire semiconductor industry. So, can Samsung ever close this gap? Well, there are plans out there that Samsung laid out. They have announced plans to develop 1.4 nanometers and 2 nanometers chip fabrication process nodes by 2027, aiming to close the technological gap with competitors. Further, they have announced plans to invest up to $115 billion to become the world's biggest chip manufacturer by 2030, including building advanced chip-making plants in the US. They even received a grant of up to $6.4 billion from the US Commerce Department to invest over $40 billion in a new chip production facility near Austin, Texas. But currently, of course, these are mere plans. But anyway, do let us know what you think. Thanks for watching.